Hello everybody, welcome to NEET Crash Course. So now we will discuss some of the practice questions from the chapter Biotechnology and its applications. The first question says, a transgenic food crop which may help in solving the problem of night blindness. So night blindness means it has to be fortified with vitamin A, and vitamin A fortified rice among the given options. As you all know, golden rice is nothing but the vitamin A fortified rice. So the correct answer is option A. The second question says, an improved variety of transgenic basmati rice, similar to what we saw, that is golden rice, it gives a high yield and it is also rich in vitamin A. So it is fortified with vitamin A through genetic engineering. So the correct answer is option A. The third question says, cultivation of BT cotton has been much in the news. What does the prefix BT mean? Now actually the prefix BT means the source of the gene, which is the Bacillus thuringiensis. So the correct answer is option B. It carries a gene for an endotoxin, which is referred to as Bacillus thuringiensis. You know that this bacteria produces a protoxin, which is activated in the gut of the insect when it feeds on the plant, and which destroys the insect soon after. So the correct answer is option B. The fourth question says, if you engineer the gene for BT toxin from Bacillus thuringiensis into a tomato plant, the resulting plant will be. So obviously Bacillus thuringiensis is a source of BT toxin, which is used as an insecticide. So the correct answer is it will be toxic to the insect that feeds on this particular tomato plant. Fifth question is, ADA is an enzyme which is deficient in a genetic disorder called severe combined immunodeficiency. What is the full form of ADA? Now, ADA is a very important enzyme in the T cells. It is referred to as adenosine deaminase. The full form of ADA is adenosine deaminase. So the correct answer is option C. Sixth question says, how many varieties of rice have been estimated to be present in India? It is about 2 lakh different varieties of rice which is found in our country. Seventh question, who grants a patent? A patent is always something which is granted by a legal system. Illegal and unlawful development of biomaterial without payment to the inhabitants of the region is referred to as biopiracy. So when you steal the intellectual property rights of another country or another region without taking or without giving them the due recognition, then it is referred to as biopiracy. Ninth question, which of the following is used as a biological warfare agent? You can use both smallpox virus and Bacillus anthracis, which is a bacteria, for bio warfare. So the correct answer is both A as well as B. Tenth question says, a false claim to novelty and invention, something which you have not invented but something which has already been in use in another foreign region. If you claim a false claim towards that invention or something that you yourself have discovered or created, then it is said that you have stolen the intellectual property, and this stealing of the intellectual property of another region or of another group of people is referred to as intellectual piracy. So option C. Human insulin is being commercially produced from. So which is the host which is used in order to express the human insulin gene? It is Escherichia. E. coli is the host in which we can express the human insulin gene. Which of these is used as a vector in gene therapy for severe combined immunodeficiency? Now in severe immunocombined deficiency, you will have to introduce the ADA gene into the T cells which are extracted from the patient. For this, you will use a retroviral vector. So retroviral vectors are used as a vector for transmitting or for introducing the gene of ADA in the T cells of a patient who is suffering from adenosine deaminase deficiency or SCID. 13th question, BT toxin is a lipid. Is it an extracellular protein or an intracellular crystal protein? It is an extracellular crystal protein. So this is something that is released by the bacterial cell in a protoxin form, and that's why it does not destroy the bacteria itself, because it needs to get activated into a toxin under suitable conditions within the gut of the insect. A genetically engineered microorganism used successfully in bioremediation, that is degradation of oil spills, is the superbug, which is named as Pseudomonas putida. 15th question, the maximum application of animal cell culture. Today, we can culture animal cells in the lab and we can usually test certain pathogens acting on those animal cells and we can devise vaccines based on them. So the maximum application today of animal cell culture technology is basically in the production of vaccines. So the next chapter, that is strategies for enhancement in food production, it includes both plant as well as animal husbandry in the same thing. So both plant breeding and animal husbandry is included here. Fish meal is a rich source of protein for cattle and poultry. Very correct. Fish meal is prepared from non-edible parts of fishes, which is non-edible by humans, but it is edible by other animals such as tail, fin, bone. Both are correct. But if you see, both assertion and reason are correct, but reason is not the correct explanation of assertion. So the correct answer is option B. So option B is the correct answer. An improved variety of cattle which is produced by controlled breeding in our country is by crossing an indigenous variety with something which is exotic, like for example brown Swiss is something which is exotic to our country and it is crossed with Sahiwal, which is indigenous, in order to obtain an improved variety of cattle. Third question, which of the following is a disease resistant high yielding breed of poultry developed in Karnataka? So something which was developed in University of Agriculture Sciences in Hebbal, Bangalore was Giri Raja. So the correct answer is Giri Raja. Fourth question, the scientific name of zebu. Now zebu refers to cows, so cow or cattle. So the scientific name of zebu or cow is Bos indicus. So option A is the correct answer. Fifth question, fish that was introduced in India by foreigners, that means it is an alien species which was introduced by foreigners, is pomfret. It is a marine fish, a marine edible fish. So correct answer is option B. Sixth question, avian pneumonia is also called. It is a disease which is referred to as the Newcastle's disease or Ranicate disease, which causes diarrhea and severe respiratory symptoms in the bird. That's why it is called avian pneumonia. Seventh question, Babesia is a protozoan. It causes tick fever in all these animals. It can cause the tick fever in cattle, in dogs, in birds, as well as in man. So the correct answer is option D. Remember, it is a disease that is, it is a protozoan parasite that causes a disease called tick fever. Eighth question, which of the following animal diseases is caused by virus? Now among the following, the animal disease that is caused by virus is Rinderpest. Rinderpest is also referred to as Steppe Murine or Cattle Plague. It is a causative. The causative of this disease happens to be a virus. So the correct answer is Rinderpest, option B. Ninth question, following are the steps of MOET program. So let us see what are the steps of MOET program. The first step is obviously you have to stimulate multiple ovulation. So this comes first, option, the statement A is the first step. That is because you are going to inject the cow with a hormone that has FSH like activity and that cow is now going to produce 6 to 8 eggs. After that, it is the second step where you either mate it with an elite bull or you artificially inseminated with the semen of an elite bull, isn't it? After that comes the third step. Now once you have obtained the fertilized eggs, you are allowing the eggs to develop into 8 to 32 cell stage, and then you will scoop these embryos out non-surgically, and the last step is where you transfer them into the surrogate mothers. So the correct sequence is A is the first step, after that is C, after that is D, and after that is B. So A, C, D, B, which is the option 1 in this given options. 10th question, isinglass is actually extracted from the air bladder of fishes. It is used in the clarification of vinegar, wines and beer. So option D is the correct answer. 11th question, cod liver oil is rich in option C. Vitamin A and vitamin D are the vitamins which occur abundantly in this cod liver oil, which is extracted from fishes. So it is option C. 12th one, smoking is used as a technique of, so smoking is a technique of fish preservation. So it is option A, it is used in fish preservation. 13th one, the term aquaculture means it not only includes freshwater culture but also marine culture. So it involves both inland fisheries, which is freshwater, and marine fisheries. So aquaculture involves both inland fisheries and marine fisheries. So it is last option, that is both A and C. 14th question is, the crop in which hybrid vigor has been utilized the most is option B, that is maize. Maize has been you can say it has been exploited to the maximum extent when it comes to plant breeding, and they have reaped the benefits of, we have reaped the benefits of hybrid vigor in this particular plant. 15th question, which of the following is a chemical mutagen? The chemical mutagens among all the following options is ethyl methane sulfonate and sodium azide. If you look at all the other options, they have physical mutagens like X-rays, UV rays, gamma rays, etc. So this is the only option that includes both of them, which are chemical mutagens. So it is the third option. So moving on to the chapter Human Health and Disease. The first question says, which of the following is a set of bacterial diseases? Now the correct answer happens to be diphtheria, coryneae bacterium diphtheriae, leprosy, mycobacterium leprae, and plague Yersinia pestis. All of them are bacteria. So the set which includes only bacterial diseases include the second option, that is option B. Second question, goose pimples are produced by, now goose pimples are papules which erupt on the skin and which are red in color, and this is seen in a disease that is referred to as scarlet fever, which is caused by the same causative that causes streptococcal throat infection, that is Streptococcus pyogenes. So goose pimple is produced by scarlet fever, so option B is the correct answer. Diphtheria is caused by, now diphtheria is caused by an exotoxin, so it is a poison that is released, it is a toxin that is released by the living bacterial cell inside the host tissue. So option A is the correct answer. Fourth question, DIC test is performed again to detect the scarlet fever. So remember, the diagnostic test for scarlet fever is the DIC test. Option C is the correct answer. Then we have fifth question, chancroid is a sexually transmitted disease which is caused by a bacteria called Haemophilus ducreyi. So Haemophilus ducreyi is the correct answer, option D. Sixth question, it is not possible to apply Coates postulate to, so we cannot apply Coates postulate to leprosy. Why cannot we apply Coates postulate to leprosy? Because you cannot isolate the leprosy causing bacteria from a patient and you cannot grow them in a culture medium. According to Coates postulate, a pathogen must be able to, you must be able to grow it in a cultured or a artificial condition like a culture medium, but that is not possible with case of leprosy, and as a result we say that Coates postulate is not applicable for the same. Mumps is a viral disease which affects, which causes inflammation of the parotid gland. So parotid glands are nothing but the largest salivary glands which cause mumps. The tests that are used in the diagnosis of HIV are Western blot and ELISA. ELISA is a diagnostic test and Western blot is a confirmatory test for AIDS. So for HIV positive, so it is last option, that is option D. The ninth question says, cancer is caused by, you know that in cancer the cells are repeatedly dividing without any break. So basically cancer is an outcome of uncontrolled mitosis. The cells of the body are repeatedly dividing and that can result in cancer. So option C is the correct answer. 10th question is opsonization. What is opsonization? In opsonization, what happens is whenever a foreign body or an antigen enters your system, the antigen is covered on all the sides by antibodies. It gets coated by antibodies so that it gets labeled and it can be recognized by your immune system. This process where an antigen gets coated by antibodies and it is recognized by, so that it is recognized by your immune system, is called opsonization. The antibody which exists opsonization to the greatest degree is IgG. So IgG or option A is the correct answer for the antibody which carries out opsonization. The predominant antibody, remember the antibody that is found in secretions is the secretory antibody, which is IgA. It is also found in the mother's milk. It is also found in the mucus secretions of your respiratory, digestive and urinogenital system. So the predominant antibody that is found in secretions such as saliva is IgA. Which of the following is equivalent to madness? Now, among all the given options, psychosis refers to a person exhibits psychotic behavior, which is equivalent to the very common and generally used term that people use, which is referred to as madness. However, the correct term is psychosis, which is a medical term. 13th one, which of the following drugs act by depressing the central nervous system? Among all the following, the drug which helps in a pain-killing property or which acts as a depressant of your central nervous system is opiate. So the correct answer is option B. 14th one, narcotic drugs like charas, bhang and ganja are extracted from hemp plant. The Indian hemp plant, that is Cannabis sativa, is a source of all these drugs. These drugs are collectively referred to as cannabinoids and they have hallucinogenic property. So 14th question, option A is the correct answer. Rauwolfia serpentina, which is the serpent plant, Rauwolfia serpentina is the scientific name. It belongs to a family. Actually, it is a source of it usually helps in production of drugs which may help in curing blood pressure disorders, hypertension disorders, isn't it? So Rauwolfia is a plant that belongs to a family that is called Apocynaceae, the same family to which hibiscus belongs to. It is referred to as Apocynaceae. So with this, we complete the practice session of all the four chapters. The four chapters including biotechnology applications, strategies including plant breeding and animal husbandry, and lastly human health and disease. So with this, I would like to say thank you.